enterprise, an institution, an organization, a hospital, a school, or home. What is the common factor which leads to success of each of these?
Team. The right team.
It's management. Can any of you tell me what is management?
Manage yourself.
Okay.
Nothing but it is manage yourself.
Okay. What else?
Art of making sure things happen. Art of making sure
making
things
sure happen. Anybody else?
I think management is about having the right team.
Having the right team.
Managing a set of people who have a different outlook to the same thing.
The meaning of management is different for different people. A worker thinks that management is an impressive person sitting in an air-conditioned office with a big chair and a table. Some people think it's commanding others. Some people think that it's just clerical work by putting fancy signatures on the checks. But management is a process of planning, organizing, directing, staffing, coordinating, and controlling the activities of an enterprise. Good morning, Madam Toastmaster, my fellow Toastmasters, and esteemed guests. An engineering postgraduate by profession, an engineer, a banker, a development banker by profession, I finally landed in an uncharted territory of manufacturing after seeing 46 springs of my life. I have over 37 years of experience as an engineer in Punjab National Bank, in a liquor industry, in a dairy industry, at Haryana State Industrial Development Corporation and Northeastern Development Finance Corporation, Guwahati. In 2006, I joined Century Group at Guwahati and worked for Star Cement Guwahati, Shyam Century Ferrous Birmingham, before finally settling at Century Ply Plasbari, where I am working in the capacity of a unit head now. During my career spanning over 37 years, I have achieved success. And I have learned various management lessons which led to that success. Today, I am going to share those management lessons which I call my success mantra with my fellow students. In 1992, I joined Haryana State Industrial Development Corporation after shifting from Punjab National Bank, Delhi. The organization had big business plans and they were planning to raise funds by way of a public deposit scheme. Since I had a banking background, they gave that assignment to me. I was at a loss to know what to do, as I had not handled any independent responsibility till then. I was working at a junior management level in the bank without any responsibility, and suddenly a responsibility was posed on me. This involved a lot of work, like taking statutory clearances from RBI, liaison with the bankers for receipt of deposits, payment of interest, publicity, printing of forms, printing of interest warrants, legal formalities, accounting, and above all, raising of resources from individuals. It appeared a very big task to me, and I started doing work, but I was not able to achieve result as I was not organized. We used to have our Monday meetings with RMD, where the progress of each task was reviewed, and I was not able to show much results. One day our MD got irritated and said, "You are not able to do anything because you are not organized. If I were you, I would have broken down all the activities. I would have written down each activity, the person responsible for that, the time required for that, and the target completion date for each activity." I got the message. In the next meeting, I presented the plan, delineating all the tasks with the responsibility of each and every person, and the target date for the completion of that activity. MD said, okay, now give me the final date of launching of the public policy. I said 15th December 1992, which coincided with the birthday of my wife. He said, okay, but in case you cannot do it, you will be on rails. I worked according to that plan, worked very hard. I was also afraid of losing my job, which I shared with my wife, and she gave me a support that nothing will happen, I am with you. Finally, the scheme was launched on 15th of December 1992. And I got the thrill of my life, because that was the first assignment which I had handled independently during the first 6 months of joining that organization. But in that hustle and bustle of launching the public deposit scheme, I forgot the birthday of my wife. Now, this experience gave me lot of lessons for lifetime. Can anybody tell me what is the lesson which I learned from that? That was the first management lesson, because I was at middle management level, and during the first 6 months of that job, I learned a big lesson which I am using till now. Can anybody tell what is the lesson?
Set goals. Set goals.
Okay.
Organize.
Okay. Very nice.
To break down your problems.
Yes. Yes.
Personal life versus job.
I'll summarize this into three parts. One is, planning is the key to success. I was not able to achieve results because I was not planned. So, in case you fail to plan, you are planning to fail. Remember that. Second is, for doing any task, team is important. In case you decide to do anything, everything on your own, which I was doing, you are bound to fail. Third is, delegate the task according to the capability and capacity of each team member to manage your time effectively. So the lesson number one, planning is the key to success. I was at 33 years of age at that time. But that lesson was a lifetime lesson which I am using till now. After that, I had the chance to handle many projects. I made use of all these three principles, and I was able to handle all these, to complete all these projects ahead of schedule. So, lesson number one, which is success mantra, planning is the key to success. When I joined Haryana State Industrial Development Corporation in 1992, as I told, I shifted from Punjab National Bank, where I was having a very cushy job, a very comfortable job. And in HSITC, I was taken at a middle management level from lower management level. So sometimes the transition from lower management to middle management is very painful. And the environment was very hostile. There was a lot of politics. And some people could not digest this, that I was taken at a middle management level, surpassing them, because they were working there prior to me. Also, to top it all, I did not have any knowledge of the work. So people would laugh at me and they would whisper that I have been recruited in that organization because I am related to the managing director, who was also incidentally a job ticket. But I was determined to succeed. I tried to learn each and everything. Everybody there was my teacher, as I started from scratch. I took help from my juniors, seniors, and there I learned so many jobs, like doing photostat. So all these jobs I did there, cyclospanning and everything. I tried to learn each and everything. Whatever was required to survive in that organization, it was a matter of my survival. I worked during late hours, on off days, Saturdays, holidays, I was working. And after a few years, I learned the whole gamut of the activities there. So much so that the people who used to teach me, they came to me asking for guidance. At that time, my performance was rated as outstanding. I not only could survive in that organization, but became ready for the higher challenges and higher responsibilities. And to share with you, I started competing with my boss. I used to tell him that I know better than him. So, what is the lesson which we get from this? Another thing, many people during that period joined that organization. Many were from banking background, and one was my senior in Punjab National Bank. They could not survive. They had to leave that organization because they could not learn the job which was required there. So the lesson which we learn is, anybody? Lesson?
Real many people are taking care of responsible towards responsibility.
Okay. Why did I survive in that organization?
Because of my
dedication. Because of my dedication.
To keep others' interest before yourself.
Okay.
So that you can learn from everyone.
Yes.
Willingness to learn.
Willingness to learn, exactly. So I'll put up it in this way, attitude to learn. Since I had attitude to learn, I could survive in that organization. I could not only survive, but also perform in that organization. So lesson number two, attitude to learn is important. If you have attitude to learn, you can survive anywhere. In 1999, after 7 years of my working at HSIBC, the opportunity to join North Eastern Development Finance Corporation at Guwahati arose. I did not know anything about Guwahati. I did not know whether it is mountains or plain. I did not know that Dispur and Guwahati are same. I always thought that Dispur is the capital of Assam, but I did not know where Dispur is. I did not know even a single person here. But the jump of 15 years in my career was more than enough to lure me to join this job, despite the fact that there was a raise of only 1,320 rupees in my pay package. At a per day 1,320 rupees raise, I was shifting, leaving my whole family there at a distance of 2,000 kilometers. Before I joined, I met the chairman NETFI. This organization is popularly called as NETFI. I met the chairman NETFI, Dr. Jant Madhav, who is an ex-executive director of Asian Development Bank Manila, at Delhi, at his residence. Does anybody know about NETFI? You know about NETFI. NETFI is a wonderful organization, which was the creation of Dr. Manmohan Singh. At that time, there were very less bankable projects and banks were not lending to any entrepreneur. So Dr. Manmohan Singh, in the budget speech of 95-96, had announced that a special institution will be set up for the development of Northeast, for the industrial and infrastructure development of Northeast, which will be out of political and bureaucratic. So it was set up in 95 and I joined in 99. When I met the chairman in Delhi, he was a bit apprehensive about my ability to adjust in the Indian land, as the area was also disturbed during that time. He asked me to keep a lien on my job at HSIBC Chandigarh, so that I could go back if I am not able to adjust in this environment. I declined to do so because I was confident that the experience and knowledge which I have gained at Chandigarh is more than enough to run a financial institution like Netfi, which is at its nascent stage. I took the plunge, joined the organization, and from middle management, I came to the senior management. Now again, that was a painful transition from middle management to senior management. You have to command about 31 persons, and believe me, all were brilliant. Everybody had dual qualification, engineer, MBA, CA, CS, ICW, CS, CS, the cream, and MBA from America, MBA from IIMs, engineering from top institutes, and I had to command those. There was a resistance from some of the people because I was the only outsider there, and another outsider was at a junior level. So only 31 persons were from this area, and I was an outsider who was put on their ground. So there was a lot of resistance at that time. But I was confident that since I have knowledge, I can do. Here also, despite all that resistance, I could survive in the alien land. I performed, and here also, my performance was rated as outstanding. What is the lesson which we learn from this? Anybody, what is the lesson which we learn from this?
That
in an alien land, from 2000 kilometers, I did not know anything, and I could not only perform, not only survive, I could perform, and the marks which I get about my performance out of 100, that was above all those 31 officers which were growing gradually. Can you tell me what is the lesson learned from this?
Knowledge and experience matters.
Yes.
That is why you were able to.
Very right, very right. Knowledge is power. In case you have knowledge, you can perform anywhere. Second lesson I have said, in case you have attitude to learn, you can survive anywhere. In case you have knowledge, you can perform anywhere. After joining Northeastern Development Finance Corporation, since it was a very nascent organization, we had a disbursement of only 14 crores. And suddenly, Prime Minister of India announced that Netfi would disburse at least 50 crore every year without asking us. We had no option but to do it. As a general manager of the corporation, I was responsible to achieve those targets. I always remember Arjuna of Mahabharata, who could only see the eye of that bird when Guru Dronacharya asked them to hit the bird's eye. So I prepared a strategy, prepared a comprehensive plan, delegated the responsibility, and on 31st March 2002, I was on top of the world, as we had done that, we had won. Does it matter how many battles you have fought? What matters is how many battles you have fought. And we had won. Have you ever taken a ride on a tonga? Have you noticed that the horse has a blinker or blinder? Why?
Because the horse
has a peripheral vision. Horse can see 360 degrees. So in case you don't put the blinders, he can see behind, the traffic behind, he can see traffic on the sides, and he can focus the way ahead. So always remember, for success, you have to put on the blinkers. Forget about what others are saying. Forget about what others are doing. Just focus on the end result. So lesson number four. What is the lesson number four? Focus, always focus on the end result. That is the key to success. So to be successful, put on the blinkers and forget about the rest. Now, the question arises, in case you don't have knowledge, and necessary skills to perform a job. Can you still succeed? Anybody, can you still succeed in case you don't have knowledge? The answer is yes. The traditional definition of management is to get the job done by others. So in case you have that capability, look at Ratan Tata. During his tenure, the revenue grew by 40 times and profit grew by 50 times under his chairmanship. But does anybody know what is his qualification? He has a degree in architecture from Cornell University, and Tata is into anything other than architecture. But he is successful because he is a great manager. So what is the lesson? Men management is the most important part of management. In case you can manage men, you can manage anything. I shifted from government sector after serving 21 years to a private sector. I did not have any knowledge, any skills. I worked in cement, I worked in power plant, I worked in ferrolies, and I am working in ply, and I had never seen a ply industry. But I have succeeded because of my ability to manage. Now, any organization in which you work, organization is good or bad in case the culture is good or bad. So a good culture means the absence of conflict and discipline, trust amongst the team, teamwork, etc., etc. So in case you work in a good organization, you are bound to succeed. I had the opportunity to not only handle two projects, but to run that organization where I have inculcated a good culture. So in case you have a good culture, you are bound to succeed. Now, these are my six success mantras, which I have learned throughout my life. I am working on that. I am still learning and improving because I have a long way to go. Henry Ford had once said, you are old when you stop learning, whether at 20 or 80, and you are young as long as you are learning. Thank you very much.